What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today it's time for another hip-hop album review. We are reviewing Aquemini from Outkast. This is Outkast's third album, released in September 1998. So Outkast is a hip-hop duo from Atlanta, Georgia, consisting of Big Boi and Andre 3000. They were basically the ones to put Southern hip-hop on the map back in the 90s. Before Outkast, when people thought of hip-hop, they mostly just thought of the East Coast and West Coast scene. But Outkast changed all that, and with this album, right here, they really solidified themselves as forces to be reckoned with. So earlier this year, I went through Outkast's discography a little bit, and listened to at least a few songs from each of their albums, and this album right here was definitely the one that clicked with me the most. Really, all of their albums have a distinct sound, and this sound here was the one I gravitated towards. One of the things I like the most about this album is how epic and grand it sounds. I can't pinpoint why that is, maybe it's the production, but this album feels like some kind of major event. It kind of feels like they're making a bold statement, something like, the South can make great hip-hop too. Speaking of the production on this album, it's incredibly lush. Apparently, they actually used live instrumentation for a lot of these beats, which I think is super cool. There's also a large variety of instruments used here, guitar, percussion, piano, synthesizer, harmonica, so the whole album sounds pretty full. Now, Andre 3000 and Big Boi are some of the most skilled rappers I've heard. They have such unique flows, it's crazy hearing them rap over some of these songs. Sometimes I'm perplexed as to how they even came up with such fast and off-kilter flows. For example, in the title track, Aquemini, Andre has this really memorable verse with a ton of internal rhymes and a really speedy flow. Just listen to the first few lines. My mind warps and bends, slows the wind, count to 10, meet the twin, Andre Ben, welcome to the lion's den, original skin, many men comprehend, I extend myself, so you go out and tell a friend. Oof. Yeah, that might be my favorite verse on the entire album. And I think Big Boi and Andre are pretty equally matched in terms of skill, so it never feels like one of them's overshadowing the other. So the album has this short little vocal intro with Hold On Be Strong, and then it hits you with Return of the G. I love this track. Immediately, the album opens with an instantly engaging beat. Yeah, it goes like this right here. It's like, The song also has a pretty catchy hook and some pretty interesting lyrics where Outkast is addressing complaints from people that they weren't real hip-hop because they abandoned their earlier, more gangster rap influence sound. And this is a common theme in the album, in the lyrics. Outkast talking about their individuality and how they're just gonna do whatever they wanna do. That and how they're proud of being from the South. The Art of Storytelling Part 1 and Part 2 are also some of the best tracks here. They both feature incredible production. Part 1 has some very interesting lyrics. Here, Big Boi is talking about a girl he wants to have sex with, while Andre is telling a pretty dark story about a girl he used to know who died of a drug overdose. So there's a very intriguing contrast between their storytelling. Part 1 also has this insanely infectious chorus. It's like that now, you better go get the hump about your bag now. It's about 4-5 cats off here, my leg now. We just shoot game in the form of story raps now. It's like that now, it's like that now. Part 2 keeps the momentum going, and the lyrics here change gears completely, as this is pretty much about the apocalypse. SpottieOttieDopaliscious is another favorite of mine. This has a very chill and relaxing sound, with a really cool bass groove, some lush guitar chords, and a pretty fun melody on the horns. The production here again is extremely impressive, as there's so many things going on, and lots of interesting effects added. Now, one of my main complaints with this album is the amount of skits. There's so many skits added throughout this album, and for the most part, I don't think they were needed. They really just kill the momentum of the album, I think. Not only do they not add anything, it detracts from my experience slightly. And I think if they had taken these skits out, the album would be a lot tighter, and Outkast still could have gotten across their messages just as well. And my least favorite song has to be Liberation. It's not that this song isn't well made, it's just not my sound at all. The whole neo-soul sound has never really been my thing, so I kind of just get bored listening to this song. And at 9 minutes, it's unfortunately also the longest on the album. And there's a few other songs here that hold this album back from being really great to me. I want to like Synthesizer, but I just don't like the George Clinton feature there. And songs like Slump and Mamacita are fine, but I don't think they have anything too special going for them. But the last track, Chonkyfire, is an amazing closer. This has a really sweet guitar riff and a really energetic vibe. I also like the lyrics here. Outkast is pretty much celebrating the fact that they can make really great songs that people really enjoy. And towards the end of this song, there's a snippet from Outkast's speech at the 1995 Source Awards. Here they won Best New Artist, and in his acceptance speech, Andre resented the fact that the South never got any respect when it came to hip-hop. He famously said the line, "The South got something to say," followed by the audience booing. And I think this is the perfect closer for this album, because it pretty much shows that he was right. I mean, they created a really solid album with real substance to it that tons of people enjoyed, and they pretty much proved the naysayers wrong. I mean, there is a skit at the end of this song, which is unfortunate, but it still ended on a pretty high note. So I definitely enjoy this album overall. It doesn't make it to that truly great status for me, but I can completely see why it's considered a classic. I'm gonna give Aquemini a 7.6 out of 10. Guys, thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, drop a like on it. If you've heard Aquemini, let me know what you think about it in the comments. And if you want to see more reviews like this, go ahead and subscribe. And I will catch you in the next one.